This video presents a short overview of the railing tool and how it's constructed using sub-elements. ARCHICAD introduces a brand new railing tool. This tool is similar to the curtain wall tool in the sense that railings also consist of a hierarchical structure of elements and sub-elements or components. Railings are constructed using various components or sub-elements, considering various settings, editable parameters, and geometry. The new ARCHICAD railings have a 3D model part and a 2D symbol part. Both the 2D and 3D parts of a railing are based on the user input, parameters, and rules. Both parts are created from the same model database using the very same railing geometry parameters. Railings are constructed by either drawing a railing reference line polyline or using the magic wand to place it on the geometry of other elements. Railings can be associatively placed on stairs, walls, slabs, roofs, and meshes, so whether their host element's geometry is modified or it's moved, the associative railing is also updated based on those changes and remains associative. A 3D reference surface is constructed based on the railing reference line. The components of the railing are generated based on this 3D reference surface. The Model View Options dialog contains a field that lets you display a schematic 3D representation of the railing, in which case only this 3D reference surface is displayed in 3D. In Railing Edit mode, let's right-click the Segments and Nodes button in the Railing Toolbox, which will make those components visible and hide all other components, a handy shortcut. Then we will see that railings are composed of railing nodes and railing segments between those nodes. The railing tool places posts at railing nodes. Railing posts are customizable GDL sub-elements that use multiple parameters to ensure exact geometry and other property specifications. Railing segments are placed between railing posts. The railing tool provides you with the ability to define a pattern for your railing segment in a graphical user interface. A pattern can be composed of one or more inner posts and one or more rails. The fields of the pattern created by these inner posts and railings can be filled by either balusters or panels or even left empty. All these components, inner posts, rails, balusters, and panels, are all highly customizable GDL sub-elements with multiple parameters to achieve the desired geometry and properties. Additionally, you can define a top rail and up to two handrails for your railing. These components all run along the entire length of the railing. Top rails and handrails are also customizable GDL sub-elements with multiple parameters to achieve the exact desired geometry. Thus, we can see that the railing tool intelligently places multiple GDL objects at its defined nodes and segments, and together these make up the structure of the railing. Each GDL object usually has at least three different groups of parameters, parameters that control the component's style and dimensions, parameters that control its 2D representation, and parameters that control its 3D representation. The railing provides many additional settings which control how the whole railing behaves and is displayed, and how its sub-elements are constructed and behave at nodes and segments. Please watch all the other clips in this playlist to fully familiarize yourself with the multitude of options and capabilities the railing tool offers.